Now, here's a sniper rifle. And a sniper rifle is great because it makes for a lot of angry comments about people who don't understand how it works. Because it's a bit... Well, it makes sense, but it's weird nonetheless, because when you use this gun without zooming in, it's useless. It's just the worst gun in the game, really. But if you zoom in, you deal a lot more damage. And in fact, if we go to this menu, which you get if you press the use button twice, where we can learn about enemies at oddly low frame rate for some reason. Not really sure why they're moving so stuttery, but what are you going to do? If you go to the weapons tab, it actually says, be sure to use the Raptor in zoom mode, since it will deliver much more damage when fired this way. And this is pretty much the only weapon where you will get helpful advice in this thing. Because a lot of these things, it's like, not high firepower, get rid of fire. It's a chainsaw. Don't use it on long-ranged opponents. Like, it's just... It makes sense not to do that, really. Also, this place is a little bit different because this door right here, you can actually just crouch through it. In the HD remake, you can't do that anymore, so... Just for the sake of trying to compare it to that version as much as possible, I'm just gonna stand over here, shoot the birds that spawned as... Natriska, I believe that's her name, said in the little text box over there. And just move along. Try not to get these guys to get too close because they can be a complete hassle. It's kind of weird that their attack sound plays even when they don't hit because it sounds like they just punch you in the face when it clearly doesn't. But I kind of would recommend not even bothering with these guys, really. Basically jump through the little hole over there because killing those guys spawns these guys, and you know, if you can avoid killing enemies, I would recommend doing it because it just makes the game a lot easier. But in this playthrough, I just want to kill things. If you pick up the boots, you can run really fast. If you see that guy, shoot him with the sniper rifle because he dies in one shot, and he shoots missiles at you, and they don't hurt as much as regular missiles, but they still kind of hurt because, well, they're still missiles. Missiles are generally not that great. We can actually run faster than those the headless kamikazes, which is great. As long as the boot power-up is active. This is generally why I don't really bother with killing everything, because on mental difficulty, it's kind of hard to see everyone, and it's very easy to miss enemies, and I highly doubt there's going to be a single level where we're actually going to reach every enemy killed, because I think there's actually a lot of levels where not all the enemies just actually spawn. So yeah, not gonna happen, I'm afraid. I think there's like one or two levels where they do actually all spawn if you do everything correctly, but I'm just not gonna bother with it, really. I'm just gonna pick up that shotgun over there just in case we didn't have it yet, and move onwards with our little boots. Gonna hold the chainsaw for no real apparent reason until we move into here. Gonna do a quick save, gonna hold the attack button, gonna kill that guy who spawns the moment you pick up that last one. And here is the last of the added weapons, I do believe. The other ones were the chainsaw and the sniper rifle, which weren't in the first encounter.
Now you're all fired.
Flamethrower is really, really good. It's probably one of the best weapons in the game, actually, for crowded situations. But not for this particular room, because I want to be conservative of ammo. And in fact, we're just going to use a chainsaw, because it works quite well for these guys. They just sort of run into you and just sort of die, really. So why not use a chainsaw? Again, any excuse to use a chainsaw is a good reason to use a chainsaw. And once again, zoom. There's a guy there. He has a minigun in his hand, and he hurts a lot. I guess it might be a girl as well. I honestly don't know, but you don't want to get shot by those people. They're just not fun. They're not fun to get shot by, and they get killed in one shot with this gun, just like the chainsaw dudes. They also die in one shot, and it makes life a bit easier. There's sadly not an extremely large amount of sniper rifle ammo, probably because it's like the best gun in the game. Like it's not very good for really crowded rooms, but for enemies like that, it's just really good because it just destroys them. Whereas even the rocket launcher, I don't think kills those guys in one shot. So yeah, sniper rifle good. And Rocket launcher also good, but a bit scary to use because you can kill yourself with it. Whereas the sniper rifle, that's a bit difficult. So, you could run over there, or you could run over here and get all this lovely armor over here. Like, there's two over there. There's another one. I would kind of recommend against this, because it just spawns a lot more enemies than, you know, is required. And I think these guys... Come on. These guys. I don't think they even spawn if you don't go into that room. And, yeah, you know. If you want to make life easy, just keep running forward. Which is generally true for everything in this game. Like, the general rule of every serious time game is to just try to avoid single armor and single health pickups, because they're generally just not worth it, really. Anyway, it's time for Chainsaw, because even though clear skeletons hurt a lot when they lunge at you like that, you can kill them quite quickly with a chainsaw, and it's quite neat. And this line makes no sense.
Hey, didn't I kick your ass 2 rooms back?
Because if you play on any difficulty, which I think is above normal, you will actually fight considerably more of those guys, but hey. That's the joke, isn't it? Instead, we're just gonna move forward. If we move close enough to that root part, more of these guys spawn! Yay! And also a guy that throws bombs. He's less pleasant. And there's actually more. I think they got stuck behind the wall, which is kind of annoying. There's a guy over there. He's kind of mean. I wonder if he dies like this. I'm kind of curious if the fire would kill him, or if it just did enough damage, sadly. Oh well. But yeah, the flamethrower is actually quite good to just use a single ammo of. Just click the button once, because it can deal a lot of damage just by doing that. Anyway, there's a secret area over here. I guess I should talk about that. It has the word mental lit up on the floor. Or at least, sort of. It has the letters lit up. If you jump on the wrong one, the ceiling comes down, which is bad. It only comes down a little bit, so you can actually just go back to the M and try again, even though if you miss the right letter, all the letters won't be lit up anymore. Which I'll just show off in a second. You don't even need to get this health. Just going into this room is the secret area. But jumping up on this, lights go out, ceiling goes down. It's a generally kind of bad place, but if you are in the situation where the door is still closed, you can just jump over there on the M. It's just a bit less obvious where the letters are, but it isn't hard. you can probably manage without the lights being turned on. So these guys kill you instantly, even if you have the amount of health I have right now, which is almost max, but for some reason I took falling damage. I'm honestly not sure how falling damage works in this game, because sometimes you take falling damage and other times you don't. And it just seems a bit random, really. But I'm just gonna take this room slowly, because I don't really want to die. I didn't really like how much I died in my first encounter playthrough, and I kind of want to fix that. There's a lava dude. He's pretty strong to the flamethrower. You probably wouldn't want to use that against someone made entirely out of fire, but he does die in a single sniper rifle shot. He does actually also die to a missile. But I don't really like using the rocket launcher in that room for obvious reasons, because you just get a wall in your face and boom. That's a rocket in your face as well, and they kind of hurt a lot, and it's rather unpleasant. Anyway, we jump down here, and there's a...
Double your gun, double your fun.
Double-barreled shotgun, which is great, but not for this room. For this room, we're actually finally going to use the flamethrower, and this thing...
Come on.
Is invulnerability for a short period of time. In the bottom right, you can see a little icon with a little timer. And this is pretty much the first room where using the flamethrower is kind of a good idea, because it just destroys these guys. And while the double-barreled shotgun, it does insta-kill one of these guys, it doesn't really work quite as fast as doing it like this. And personally, I just prefer this method. I think one more should spawn. I was wrong. Okay. Look over there. Oh, no, wait. I was wrong. One more did spawn. I guess the power-up just needs to run out before the last one spawns. Let's look over there for a moment. Hey, then... Oh, I missed. That's mean. I think that's the first time I've ever missed that guy. But, yeah. Make sure you don't get hit by that guy, because he's a loser. I don't like that guy. He's just there to waste some more sniper rifle ammo. Anyway. Game immediately gives you more flamethrower ammo after clearing that room, which, you know, it's nice. It's nice that the game does that. Try not to get crushed here. Ceilings, still bad. Don't really want to get crushed by them. That kind of goes for the entire game. Pretty much every moment where the ceiling comes down, it will probably insta-kill you. And getting insta-killed is just not very fun. It's a sad way to go, really. But press the two buttons again. The use button is by default the right mouse button. And yeah, just press the two buttons. It's not very difficult. I still don't really know why the right mouse button is the use key, but it's something they did for the first and second encounter, and I think they did for the HD remakes as well, and it might not be immediately obvious to anyone who's not played this game. I know the first time I played this game, I think I actually resorted to pressing, like, backslash because I couldn't figure out what the use button was. But then again, I was, like, 12 when I first played this game, so what are you gonna do? But shotgun our way through. We can actually... That sound you just heard is one of those minigun people. Gonna shoot two rockets in that direction because that's how much it takes to kill one of them. One sniper rifle shot or two rockets. I don't really understand why, because other enemies, you need three sniper rifle shots or three rockets, and I don't really understand how damage works in this game, to be perfectly honest. Anyways. Chainsaws are bad. And the following enemy agrees with that statement, but he also agrees that fire, in fact, a single shot of fire, is quite bad as well. I love that. I love that sound effect, and I don't know why, but I just do. And I forget about that guy. But yeah, those guys, if you hit them once with the flamethrower, they just die, just every single time. And that's good. I believe the logic behind it is that they come from, like, a planet where all of their skin is burned off, and the people that have some skin left become soldiers, and the people that have more skin left become commanders or something like that. It's a pretty weird place to live, but apparently those guys have not much armor in that sense, and not much skin either, and everything hurts, so any hit will just stun them, and they just get killed easily. Anyway, armor here. If you pick it up, armor spawns behind you, which is cool. And if you jump down, there is a rocket launcher waiting for us. Not really sure what it landed on there, but sure, what are you going to do? And if you jump down here, there's a teleporter, and it brings you all the way up here. But for the sake of killing as many things as possible, I'm actually going to jump back down again and go around this area. Because otherwise, it doesn't spawn a bunch of enemies. The trigger is, in fact, over there. And with a bunch of enemies, I also mean that guy who sneakily stands behind us, trying to kill us like that. Oh, I actually got hit by that one. That's unfortunate. And I guess I'm not sure if it spawns that green guy or not. But it definitely is there right now, so it's something we need to take care of. Three rockets or three sniper rifle shots takes care of them, but the thing to remember is that the rocket can hit the green balls as well, and then it just explodes without hitting the actual guy itself. And then you just need to shoot another rocket or another sniper rifle bullet, and it just takes a bunch of time, so sometimes it might actually be better to just use a sniper rifle, but that time I didn't accidentally hit one of the green balls, so all was good. Boom! Anyway, another rocket launcher. This is the third one this level. Ready to rocket. And there is a very inconspicuous rock over there, which I'll get to in a second. You can actually use the rocket launcher to destroy trees as well, which is cool. You can actually stand over here as well if you feel like being brave, because there's a bull coming towards you and he just sort of jumps down. And that instantly kills it, which is nice. The only problem is if you get hit, you're probably gonna die. Which, you know, it just depends on how much it's worth it for to you to kill him in an awesome way. And I find that very, very important. But yeah, green guys are annoying. Kill them at all times because it's a problem when you can't actually see them. And they just keep shooting you because they have the range of the gods. If I'm standing on the other side of the level, but there's nothing in between us, they will start attacking me. And those things will try to kill me as just very gladly. They are very eager to just destroy me, and it's very sad when they do. And I'm going to kill this guy now, because otherwise we're going to hear that sound for a very long time. And while the sound of chainsaws is very relaxing, I don't really like it when they're not mine. He should be dead. Not really sure why he weren't, but he wasn't. It makes me sad. But yeah, this rock right here, it's a bit inconspicuous. I'm not sure if it actually hints that there is a rock here which may lead to a secret tunnel, but if you hit it, boom. Secret cave has been discovered. I think you can actually use one of the kamikazes as well to destroy that rock. But I'm not actually sure about that, so I might just be lying right now. Either way, once again, hold the C button or the crouch button to swim considerably faster until it stops looking like it's going faster, and then just kind of press the crouch button and the jump button over and over until the jump button seems to be going faster, because it is very, very possible to drown in this place. And the only thing we're really getting out of this is health, but also 5 sniper rifle ammo and points. Points, of course, being the most important thing, because otherwise it doesn't show off that we got all the secrets, which we can get at the end of the game. Which, you know, it's actually impossible to get all secrets, but I find it very important nonetheless. I guess that you only need to destroy... Oh, no, wait, you do actually get more for the secret health. I thought you didn't, but I guess you do. I think I just skipped a trigger right there. So let me just run back. Because this is how people play games. You run back to trigger some enemies that haven't spawned yet because you jumped over it by going into a secret area. Because these are lava dudes. They generally shoot where you are. There's actually bigger versions of them as well. And they sort of predict where you're going to be. But these guys just shoot where you are at the time. So as long as you move, they shouldn't hit you. It's the bigger ones where you actually need to be a little bit more careful. But fortunately, he died and we have nothing more to worry about. Except for missing every single sniper rifle shot in the game. Which is something I've been doing quite prominently now. And also, it would have been a good idea not to just forget about these guys and go head first into a bunch of those skeletons. But hey, sometimes I forget things and it happens and it makes me sad when I do. But you know, I'm only human. Now this place is kind of cool. There's a guy there. Shoot it with rockets because they hurt. There's also some people over there. I think they are actually waiting for you on top of the thing. Like that thing over there, and as you come close, they start to fly towards you. But if you shoot them a couple times, they stop flying, which is quite nice, because when they're no longer flying, they're just considerably less dangerous. They seem to run a lot less slow than they can fly, and it's good. It's kind of what you want. And this area is also kind of interesting, because there's a bunch of platforms here. There is a secret area in the water. Not going to get it quite yet, because it actually spawns a bunch of enemies the moment you jump into the water over here. And I kind of want to stand over here and then immediately go out, because anyone who's played Serious Sam will know that fish are awful. Fish are the worst enemies you can face, which is a bit odd. The way their attack works is I'm pretty sure they just programmed voodoo magic, and based on that, it just tries to decide how much damage their attack does, because sometimes it doesn't deal any damage at all, and other times it just destroys you. I just don't understand how it works, but they can either be really nice or really, really horrible. And if you're standing over there, you can actually spawn them over there as well by just jumping over in the water over there. The thing is, they jump on land. They don't care that they're not in the water. They jump on land and still try to electrocute you. And I generally just find a lot safer to just kill them while standing over here. But that ends this level. That's actually everything there is to do in this level. That is the end over there. And because I feel like I'm just going to break these statues over here. Something you can do. It doesn't really help, but I just like breaking things, really. It's very satisfying to break giant heads. Not really sure why. And we got 12 out of 12 secrets in this level. And 12 out of 13 secrets in the entire game because of that lovely secret in the intro cutscene. And that's actually where I'm going to end this video right here. So I hope you enjoyed it so far. And next time we play, we're going to level 2, the Valley of the Jaguar. And we're probably going to get all those secrets as well. We're actually going to miss one secret in that level, but you'll see why when we get there. So hope you enjoyed and hope to see you when the next video comes up. Bye-bye.